What if you're wrong?
What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick. It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
King in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
I can feel the dead in the air.
You can feel the dead.
Why would Tyrfing do this?
Turn back.
Don't go in there. Go in.
You have to
go
in.
Take the torch.
It's too dark.
Take it.
Dillion, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
There he is.
There he is.
Dillion.
There he is. Finally.
You found him. What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me?
How did you let him go again?
Just wait there. I'll find you.
You have to find him.
This is your mission. Find him.
You have to use everything you have and find him. Get him back.
He was just there. How could you lose him? How could she lose him?
How could she? Find him.
I'll find him.
What's that? Did you hear that?
Nothing.
Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillion.
Dillion's calling to you. Can
Where
you
is
hear
he? Where is he?
He sounds like he's getting further away.
Have you lost him?
You're going the wrong way.
Are you lost and have you lost him?
Where are you? Turn left.
Senua. You remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrfing. Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, Her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires, as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Find another way. It's not working. You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find another
think.
Way.
Think. Focus. Use your
it's
mind.
Not him. It's not him.
We told you. We told you it was a trick.
It's not Dillian. Wants me to face my fears. Father? I'm leaving. Decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it in my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief, that's him.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing
no.
inside you,
no.
they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Killing you would be too easy. They're taking your memories to torture you. They're taking you from the inside.
You're disappearing. One memory
at a time.
Every time you remember, it disappears.
They're going to take everything.
They're not yours anymore.
They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
They belong to the gods, not to you. They want your mind, and they're going to take it.
The memories were yours, but they're the gods now.
Nothing is yours anymore.
Dillian's disappearing with your memories.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. And there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I think I'm somewhere else now. The breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
Reach the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of you. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father, he taught me the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the sword. I'm no coward. proved that for me in the Warrior Trials. This is just another battle. You can beat him.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help him.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best. Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
I think I'm in.
The darkness is testing you. You are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Delia. Help me.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And his sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind and become a warrior in Dillion's clan.
Go back.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
Years later, with Zinbel's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. A plague.
Tell you?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
She's going to die.
No, she isn't. The
mirror.
The mirror.
Her focus is coming back. Stop!
She will die. Stop. Nowhere to run to.
In the sea of corpses, the corpse waved through itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Suffering, Senua. Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinlo, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Thank you.
hear the voice of your mother, Galena. She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Don't give up.
fight on. Maybe you too should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas of the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Darkness has taken you, Galena and Senua. Galena and Senua.
You are lost. There's nothing you can do. You're dead. You're dead. Mother and daughter dead in the sea of corpses. The voices took her and they'll take you too.
The voices have taken her.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong. Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me?
Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me.
Hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope.
You know who I am? I'm the elf, okay?